Potato is a tuberous crop that was first domesticated in the current region of Peru and northwestern Bolivia between 8000 and 5000 BC. It has been imported in Europe 4 centuries ago, and it was vulgarized in France by Mr. Parmentier. That is the origin of the hachis parmentier. Before that, people did not know how to cook them, so they gave them to the pigs. The Food and Agriculture Organization of UN reports that the world production of potatoes in 2013 was about 368 million tons, two-thirds of which are directly eaten by humans. So, potato is an essential crop in Europe where, per person, the production is the highest in the world. Several international organizations highlighted the potato's role in the world economy, since it's a cheap and plentiful crop that grows in a wide variety of climates. For all these reasons, we decided to talk about a potato, but not about eating it. We will see it can be a lot more fun.
With potatoes, one can also generate electricity. But let me first explain how batteries work. From everyday life batteries to car batteries and even cell phone batteries, many of them rely on galvanic cells to transfer chemical energy into electric energy. They depend on two metals, a cathode or positive terminal such as copper and an anode or negative terminal such as lead or zinc. These are placed in an electrically conductive solution that allows ions to travel freely between the two metals. The solution is typically an acid. Car batteries use sulfuric acid, but potatoes contain phosphoric acid, which also works. The acid steadily eats away at the negative terminal, a chemical reaction that releases oxides and spare electrons. These electrons then join with spare hydrogen ions in the acid to create hydrogen gas. Meanwhile, the copper isn't doing anything in its acid bath. That is until you connect it to the anode using a conductive wire. The spare electrons are still intent on forming hydrogen gas, but they have an easier time doing it with the hydrogen surrounding the anode. This is an electric potential. So, the electrons from the cathode travel through the wire to get to the anode. Batteries exploit this flow of electrons, allowing us to use their combined electricity.
One potato, two potatoes, three potatoes, four, five potatoes, six potatoes, seven potatoes more.
And now let's give a warm welcome to the potatoes in the battery world. Potato batteries typically use a zinc galvanized nail and a copper penny. Here, we choose to use zinc and copper discs placed between slices of potato. A zinc galvanized screw and a simple copper wire will act as terminals. When connected together, a flow of electrons forms. It can be used to power a light bulb, thus producing light. One can also use a magnet connected to a terminal and a free wire placed between the other terminal and the magnet. The wire starts spinning under the magnetic field formed in this way. This is a motor of the simplest kind. The potato isn't the only supermarket item that meets the mandatory chemical requirements. One can conduct the experiment with almost any fruit or vegetable, or an electrolyte solution such as Gatorade, which also contains phosphoric acid. And that's how you get an electro potato.
Starch is composed in a large number of glucose units joined by glycosidic bonds. Dissolving starch in warm water gives wheat paste, which can be used as a thickening, stiffening, or gluing agent. When heated in water, the granules of starch swell and burst. The semicrystalline structure is lost and the smaller amylose molecules start leaking off the granule, forming a network that holds water and increasing the mixture viscosity. This is then dried under high heat, which causes the rest of the uncooked starch in glue to swell, gelatinize. The gelatinizing makes the glue a fast and strong adhesive. A spud gun is a pipe-based cannon which uses air pressure or combustion of a flammable gas to launch projectiles at high speeds. You have a fuel air mix in the chamber and then an ignition source which will ignite that flammable mix. When the vapor ignites, the resulting explosions create a large volume of hot gas which forces the potato down the length of the barrel and out.
They're red, they're white, they're brown. They get that way underground. There can't be much to do. So now they have blue ones too. We don't care what they look like, we'll eat them. Any way they can fit on our plate. Every way we can conjure to heat them. We're delighted and think they're just great. Potato, 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 potato.